lukewarm calls because they're advertising or Facebook. You find people all the time. How do you call them up and not sound like a robot or sound like a, do you think sounding like a salesman will get you 99% rejection? Absolutely. So how do we get somebody so they don't make an instantaneous negative judgment on us? We do different things, like we do familiarity. Okay. So if I call up Chris Logan, ring ring, Chris.
Yeah, hey, this is Chris.
Hey Chris, it's Claude, man. I'm sorry it took me so long to call you. Hey buddy, how's the family? How's everybody doing?
Oh, it's going good. Going good.
Who the hell are you?
Yeah.
But
Yeah, who are you again?
yeah, I'm Claude Diamond. Listen, and so sometimes I'll segue and I'll combine some of these. I'll do familiarity and then I'll go, I'm confused, or I'll go to apology or even referral. So if I called up Chris, how's everybody doing? I'm so glad I got you on the phone. Chris, I'm a little confused. I got your phone number here on a post-it. Okay, and I've been moving this back and forth on my desk. I'm sorry. Why are we talking today? This isn't about real estate, is it?
Well, I am in real estate. I'm not sure why the post-it's there, but I'm in real estate.
Oh, okay.
Not sure what it could be.
I don't either. Are you looking? So a lot of people call me because they want me to buy something or they want to sell me a property. Well, that isn't what we're talking about today, is it?
Yeah, I actually have a property that we're looking to unload here in Tampa, Florida.
Oh, but it's sold already. It's probably in, you've got a contract by now, right?
No, we don't actually. It's still
Oh,
available.
you know what? Can I ask you two, three quick questions? And you ask me a few, and I'll make you an offer, and maybe we'll move forward, or maybe it'll be over.
Sure, that sounds good.
Oh, you're such a, you're, man, you're the best person. I've had a tough day today. Thank you so much, man.
Yeah, no problem.
You're nice to me. Thank you. Okay, off the role play. I went from familiarity. I am confused. I even did an apology. Yeah, I'm so sorry. I'm so embarrassed. Boom.
Gotta be a thespian.
You've got to be authentic. You've got to be a thespian. You've got to be very relaxed. You got to be in that frame of mind where, do you think sometimes people can tell what the phone call's about by our tonality, by the way we sound? Okay. I have this thing. I get a lot of people calling me up. Hi, how are you today? What goes in your mind when you hear that right away?
Scripted salesman.
Scripted salesman, right? So if I call somebody up, hi, Justin, ring, ring.
Hello.
Hey, Justin, Chris Logan. You don't know who Chris is. Chris Logan told me to give you a call, man. Maybe you can help me with this problem.
Okay, how do you think I might be able to help?
Chris said great things about you. And Chris said that you buy pro. I got this one property here and I'm trying to set it up as a lease purchase and I need a contract. Can you help me?
I don't know. I don't know, Claude. I guess it depends. I mean, you'll have to tell me more about what the opportunity is, and then I'll tell you. I'm probably going to ask you a couple questions, and you can ask me a few. And if it's not a good fit, we'll just decide that we'll both tell each other no. Is that okay?
That's a great boom. Don't off the role play. Brilliant, by the way. Do you see how Chris and Justin, how these guys go all into the, they use the gut system. They go right in the beginning there to agenda. You've got